Hey guys, and welcome to another Guild War. Today we have Kitty's Palace again. Okay, so there's only one green tower. We'll finish that guy off, and we should be fairly close to finish off the war. So yeah, we'll hit a couple of yellow guys after that. Ooh, I don't like versing this sort of team. Right, so first team, I think we can do. Maybe not this guy. Let's bring Kumar. He's got a lot of sustain here. All of them can heal, so I think this is a good time to use destroy runes. And I want to cleanse, right? Because I can't really afford for the debuffs to from the two tricks to hit me. So let's run with that. I don't really have any buffs, so Praha's Predicted Future won't do much. Well, she can remove Kumar's speed buff, but whatever. Alright, now, second team. This team's not so easy. Usually, what I will probably do is run Triple Will to begin with. And I just double revive. It's very risky, but the goal will be to take out the Sierra ASAP, and hopefully I can survive his Field Mars going crazy. Okay, Will's fine. I actually think Will is like him having Will is better for me, because this team is like a very long sustaining team, and then his Will runes, yeah, he gets like a benefit on turn one, but after that, now Will runes, he's just using them for stats, right? Meanwhile, I have revenge. Well, no, that's not revenge. I have destroy runes, so I have more long a better long game because of that, right? Compared to Will. Actually, I'm not gonna trick yet. So I'll keep working on the Ritesh. I was trying to stun the Kumar. Oh, good stun. Right, now I'll trick, so like, since Praha was already slept before. And oh damn it, I didn't get the heal block. Which would have been nice, because I was preparing for the meditate on the Ritesh, but well, he's gonna get healed up a little bit now. Wow, X is doing some work there. Okay, we'll wake up Kuma. So even because I. Even if he got the heals, it wouldn't have been too bad, since I had I destroyed part of his HP already. Resurge and just keep working on. Well, I'll just split the DPS a bit, I guess. Let's bring him up. There's no more armor break now. We'll wake up the Kumar. Oh my god. Not getting the debuffs though. But, I mean, they do have resist lead, so it's not that surprising. I'll just ignore the Praha for now. Alright, now we can go for the trick again. Just keep pressuring them. Do I get the move? Oh, good. I wasn't sure if I would steal the turn, because he's got the speed buff on the Kuma. His attack bar is pretty high. Yeah, that was a good turn stealing, so I could move in between and grab the Oh shit. Wow, he's kidding me? Okay, that was a good violin. But it's annoying now because I don't have Endure anymore to sustain me. Another Fulmar is gonna hit. I need to refresh and get some heals up. Oh man, I need violent procs. Alright, Sierra's down at least, but now I'm worried about the Fulmars. I don't have any more defensive buffs. Oh god, don't stun me! Oh my god! No! Come on, I need to get... Guess I'll do that. Iona, stay alive. Oh god. Okay, she's gonna heal up, so she won't die to the dot. And she can heal up now, I think. As long as she doesn't get stunned. Alright, good. Oh, it's close. Oh god, she violent out of her anti-crit buff. Oh, but then again, she did heal again. Alright, so let's take out this guy. Oh, that was a lot scarier than I thought it would be. So you can see there's a risk there. It's not foolproof, but I did have sustain to, you know, try to push for it. Alright, so everyone else is yellow, so I'm just gonna hit a couple of yellows to try to push up. Push through. I think I can pretty much do the same for the first. Except I always switch in Chasun for more the attack buff and better healing. And the second team, I think I'm just going to do the same here as well. Yeah, pretty much his only threat is Fulmar, so he's basically just trying to protect him, right, with the Molly and Konamiya. So if I just bring two supports on my one, I think I should just win in the long term. Because my supports, I would say, are stronger than those two, at least in terms of healing. Okay, I'll try to put glancing again. Oh my god, come on. Third time lucky? Oh my god. Can't believe it. I mean, it's not a big deal, but I had three chances to do it. It should have worked. Okay, this is good at least. The Daydream will do nothing. Take him out. Alright, so it's number threat. And I guess I can do that. Alright, now we can just order the Praha. Excuse me. Okay, alright, so we'll just go for we'll just focus on the single threat, right? He's got no revive or anything, so we can just go for him. He's gonna get, the defense break's gonna get removed, but that's okay. I popped the Endure, surprisingly. Just hit someone else, I guess. Okay, we'll just finish him off. Okay, we can pretty much just auto these last two guys. We'll just focus the economy to make it quicker. Oh my god, how many turns? I think she's violent procced every turn. At least she was alone, but it's annoying seeing that many violent procs. Let's try this one. Alright. I think for the first team, we'll just put Konamir back in, that way I can tank the Ritesh with him, and I can cleanse stuns, right? As long as he doesn't get stunned. And the second team... Alright, so the Draco should move first, unless he's slower than my Field Mars, which is unlikely, but I don't know. The spare Dracos are around low 200 speeds, usually, so it'll be close. Probably don't need the supports, like those two supports. Maybe I'll just do this one, just to be safe. Yeah, I'll go with this. I've been sort of moving away from the Bella Delphoi combo in favor of like a safer, you know, reviver healer team. Just because I do find that sometimes I lose just because of bad RNG, you know, from violent procs or failing to buff remove or reset, you know, that sort of RNG. So I think I'll just try this. Oh, someone said hello to me. I'm kind of recording at the moment though. Okay, we finish off this guy. Revive, that's fine. Maybe we can try to work on the Eladriel while he's low. Oh, never mind. I'm gonna go back on the Veramos because I don't like his stuns, right? Peace again. And he's got destroy anyway, like destroy HP. Alright, now we work on Eladriel again since he can revive the Veramos. We can do Trick of Fire. I think the heals are down, but that's fine. Oh my god, how many turns did he get? Okay, just keep bringing the monkey dip to put in. Oh my god. That's alright, he's very low, so as long as I can maybe I'll heal up Economia. Oh, that's a good violent proc. I can hopefully take out the Eladriel soon. Stun? Nope. It's painful. Right, come on, take him out. Right, good. I got peace, so I can heal up, get rid of debuffs. Okay, let's refresh him. Should be just auto the Kuman. Oh, it's in the Ritesh now. I'm really liking this team. Seems to be quite safe. Like, you know, this sort of variation of team. Oh, he was slower than me. Maybe I could have done the Bella team, but that doesn't matter. Alright, it's buff attack, and we're gonna try to pop the Endure straight away. That did not work, but alright, we'll try to attack debuff. Alright, got the attack power down and popped in jaw, so that's really good. Okay, I survived, so we should be able to take him out now. Alright. I feel Orion's probably not, so not Orion, Draco's not good enough, you know, compared to, say, what an Orion would do for this team. Yeah, so he was a despair, Draco. So that Draco was probably about, like, you know, just over 200 speed. Maybe around like 205 to 210, my guess. And yeah, the Field Master is quite tanky to be used as the HP leader. That's probably like the only thing that Draco really brings for him. I mean, he does boost the attack bar and give immunity, but I don't think, unless he's going to be really fast, it's probably not good enough. Alright, so that's all three attacks. Let's just do War Boss. I already cleared my wings before earlier. I kind of forgot that I was going to do Arena as part of the videos at the end. I can grab some, like, maybe I can just grab three wings from the daily and just do a few, because I think I'm pretty high in Guardian, or near Guardian at least, so the fights will be a bit more interesting there. Oh, just barely out of SS. Very shitty drops here. Praha number one, not surprising. I got my second Reno so low compared to the first one. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, hopefully I can get an S on this one as well. That's pretty good. So much mana. Oh shit, I forgot. Damn, I tapped the wrong section of the screen. A plus? Okay. But yesterday we got triple S, right? Which is pretty good. Hopefully we can try to get... hopefully I can make it a bit more consistent to get it up there. Okay, I think I definitely could upgrade some runes on some of these monsters here that I've been shown. I think some of them don't have max runes, like maybe Jabel. I'm pretty sure Jabel does not have max runes, so... probably boost that team up a bit. Alright, let's just collect the daily wings. Oh, one second. Okay, so we can just clear a few wings here just before the video ends. Oh, that's a very interesting team. Let's bring this. Just want to snipe that Joltan straight away. Oh, okay, never mind. Can't do that. In that case, okay. I was hoping to take out the Platy, but I guess. Go for the Chloe instead then. Wow, he hit pretty hard. Well, I'll take out the Platy now so that she doesn't revive. Actually, I'm gonna die to the Reflect, but wonder if I can take him out with the first skill and the Rageful Return in one go. That's kind of cool. Alright, now we pretty much just burst down the arena now. Actually, even my Bernard's first skill poked him a little bit. So his HP is not super high. Hey, the main way I deal with arenas is either Tor or Tashar. And I used to use Pungbaek for it too, so instead of Samath, I had Pungbaek as the leader. So I didn't have speed lead, but I had crit lead. And like double big burst nukes. And he also has heal block for the shield as well, which is quite nice. Okay, we'll fight speed with speed. No war runes. I'm actually surprised to see Rakan like up here. It's probably not his real defense, you know, for rush hour and stuff. Actually, I probably should use Bernard to kill his Bernard, but oh well. Let's finish up the last two, hopefully. So this one, I'll bring Tashar. The main threat is the Sierra, right? So Tor's not great for that. But I still have Samath for water DPS against the Juno anyway. So it's mainly the Sierra I care about. Maybe the Anvil to an extent. This is not quite so easy. Just have to go with this. Double fire with a tanky retouch is not something I like to hit, typically. Thankfully, he has no will runes though, so that actually makes my job a lot easier. A lot more doable. I'm not sure if Tempest is gonna kill. Oh, okay. That was pretty close on the retesh. But yeah, I was hoping that's the main one I wanted to kill. To be honest, I didn't really pay attention to whether I reset the field Mars or not. Alright. There's one more, but I don't have any more wings, so yeah, there's one more here. That defense, I wasn't really sure on how I'm going to hit it yet, so I left it to last. Let's just do a wish. Maybe we'll get more wings from this. Or like a good thing to land on for once, like a monster. Nah, it's 10,000 mana. Oh, energy. And that's a little bit better. Nothing in shop. Alright, so I'm gonna leave it here. Thanks guys for watching. Tomorrow there won't be a Guild War video, but I will be doing a summoning session for my birthday and with some friends, and I'm gonna record like my side of the summoning session. We're all gonna like just talk on Discord and like we all summon at once basically. This is what we usually do for everyone's each person's birthday. We just organize that amongst ourselves, and yeah, so that should be fun. I have quite a few summons to do, and I'm gonna buy. I saved up a few, but I'm gonna buy a pack for because it's a special occasion. So I'll see you guys then. Have a good one. Bye bye.